Bacteria are used to prepare vaccine also. And what is vaccine? So you Faria Javed told that they helpful to make cheese and curd. They helpful in pickling. Now you are telling they help to prepare vaccine. So what is vaccine? Very good. But my question was, what are vaccines? What is actually vaccine is? Option, yes, option, option. Vaccine is actually a special preparation of dead and weakened disease causing germ. So vaccine is nothing, they just they can be dead or weakened disease or disease causing organism, and they can be toxoid, means the organism release the toxin, that can be, and that helps to prevent from many diseases like typhoid, tetanus, cholera, TB, diphtheria, etc. Yes. Tuberculosis, yes. Now, Iman, tell me some other uses of bacteria. Useful, I ask you uses of bacteria. Some they told, now few you can add. They help to prepare vitamins also, vitamin B complex and vitamin K. So, yes. They help to increase the digestion, like probiotics. Probiotics can be formed with the help of lactic acid and acetic acid. They increase the digestion. Means with the help of probiotics, digestion related problems are solved. They improve the digestion. Now rating of jute fiber. So rating of jute fiber means separating the jute fiber from the stem. Means the jute fiber from the jute stem. How they separate? They separate with the help of bacteria. They leave the jute stem in the water with the bacteria. So these bacteria decompose the middle wall of the fibers, and as a result, fibers are separated. And these fibers are used for many things, to make clothes or different other things. Different jute items are available in the market. So they are formed with the help of jute fibers. and jute fibers are separated with the help of bacteria. And this separating of jute fiber from the stem is known as jetting of jute fibers. Got it? Food processing. Jute fiber. Bacteria, yes, yes. Okay, recycling of nutrient, that is also done with the help of these bacteria. Some of the bacteria, they, like I told you, saprophytic bacteria, so they are actually very helpful for our environment, and they actually the very good friend of us, because the complex organic matter means the dead organic matter, or you can say the dead bodies of different plant and animal, they decompose with the help of some bacteria, saprophytic bacteria. They can convert the complex organic compound into the simpler one. So, and these simpler substances are actually the nutrient for the plant. So these simpler nutrients, they can be absorbed by the plant. So they are very important for the plant growth. So some of the bacteria, they are helpful in recycling of nutrient as well. Then nitrogen fixation. Some bacteria are capable to convert atmospheric nitrogen into the usable form of nitrogen. Means nitrogen is very important for our growth. As we know, the protein is the bodybuilding nutrient. So, you know, this protein basic constituent is nitrogen and hydrogen, amine group, NH3. Means nitrogen and hydrogen combined to form amine group, and so many amine group combined to form protein. So this protein is very important. But a lot means 78% nitrogen is there in the atmosphere. All the animals and human being, they are unable to use that 78% nitrogen which is there in the atmosphere. We cannot use directly from the atmosphere. We use oxygen. So in this way, we cannot use nitrogen. So some of the bacteria, they capable to convert atmospheric nitrogen into the usable form of nitrogen, so that the plant can use, so that the plant can absorb. So nitrogen fixation can be possible because of some bacteria. The name of the bacteria is Rhizobium bacteria. RHIZOBIUM. Rhizobium bacteria. So there are two group of nitrogen fixing bacteria. They can be free living bacteria like Clostridium, found in soil or air, and they can be symbiotic bacteria. So symbiotic bacteria is the rhizobium bacteria just now I told, means they live in the root nodules of leguminous plants. Leguminous plants, protein rich plants like beans and pea and all. So in their roots, the swollen parts are there. They are called root nodules. On the root, like you can see here the picture 2.8. And this the root nodules are there. In these root nodules, these bacteria are living. And this type of relation is known as symbiotic relation, you can say, and symbiotic association, because here they mutually help each other. They help each other. Bacteria provide nitrogen to the plant, and plant provide shelter as well as the food to the bacteria. So they both are help each other. So this type of association is known as symbiotic association. On the other hand, some bacteria are free living, and they also able to convert atmospheric nitrogen in the usable form of nitrogen, so that the plant can absorb. Because plant or animal or human being, they cannot use atmospheric nitrogen directly from the atmosphere. So The nitrogen, usually the plant means how we get the nitrogen, the dead organic matter that is decomposed, in that the nitrogen is there. And when these saprophytic bacteria or the decomposer, they convert dead organic matter into the simpler form, so these plants absorb. So in this way, the nitrogen goes into the plant, and we eat plant, animal eat plant. So through the animal and the plant, the protein comes to our body also. So in this way, means like the nitrogen cycle is, means how it comes to us and how do we utilize it. How do it come in our diet? So it comes from the plant and animal, and plant take from the soil, and means it's there in soil because of the decomposer. Because the dead organic matter, when it decomposed, then only this nitrogen goes into the soil, and that is absorbed by the plant. Understood? So now tell me, what is recycling of nutrient? Juvaria bint Shahid, tell me, what is recycling of nutrient? One at a time. Everybody started together. One at a time. Yes. Yes. Yes, Salama. Salama, you tell me first. I ask, what do you understand with this cycling of nutrients? Yes. Afshan, you tell me. Yes, okay. Okay, you tell Umar. I asked recycling of nutrient. Recycling of nutrient means some of the bacteria, they help to decompose the dead body of plant and animal. They convert their complex organic compound into the simpler substances so that the plant can absorb. So this is called recycling of nutrient. Means the nutrient which is gone into the plant and animal, how it comes back to the soil. This is recycling. And that can be possible because of the decomposer. Some of the bacteria and fungi, they are the decomposer. They decompose the complex organic matter into the simpler organic substances. Okay. Aqib, you tell me, what is nitrogen fixation? Yes, I asked from Aqib. Tell me. I asked nitrogen fixation. I ask nitrogen fixation. So nitrogen fixation means some of the bacteria they help to they capable to convert atmospheric nitrogen into the usable form of nitrogen or absorbable form of nitrogen so that the plant can absorb. Then some bacteria help in genetic engineering also, and some bacteria helpful in biological treatment. So now harmful bacteria. Some bacteria are harmful also. They harm us in many ways. They can cause disease, they can spoil food, they can cause food poisoning. So like some of the bacteria, they spoil the food. So they grow on old vegetable and fruit, even meat, bread and other perishable food items, and the food item get spoiled and become unfit for human consumption. So some of the bacteria they live on the old vegetable and fruit meat, and they decompose and they spoil the food. Now some bacteria produce certain harmful chemicals called toxins. Means some of the bacteria they cause food poisoning. Why? Because they release some toxin, some chemicals in the food, and when that food is consumed by somebody, then it causes food poisoning. Means when some bacteria they causes food poisoning, they releases some toxin, some chemicals, and when someone will consume that type of food in which these type of bacteria release the toxin, that is that causes food poisoning. Clostridium botulinum is a common bacteria that infect canned food. The food comes in packing in the canes. Usually those food is that food is spoiled by Clostridium botulinum. And disease causing bacteria. Some of the bacteria they cause disease in human being, plant and animal, all. So such organism that cause disease are called pathogen. Means those bacteria which causes diseases in plant, animal, human being, they call pathogen. PATHOGEN. So pathogen are actually the disease causing organisms. Here Muhammad Abdullah. Am I audible to you, Muhammad Abdullah? Pathogen. What is pathogen? Pathogen, PATHOGENS, pathogen. What are pathogens or what is pathogen? Very good. So disease causing organisms are called pathogen. Here some common bacterial diseases are there: cholera, tuberculosis, tetanus, typhoid and botulism. Here is a list or the table on the page number 40. Cholera is caused by Vibrio cholerae. Tuberculosis is caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Tetanus is caused by Clostridium tetani. Typhoid fever is caused by Salmonella typhi. And botulism, that is the food by due to the cane food. That is because of Clostridium botulinum. So all of you repeat: Vibrio cholerae, Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Clostridium tetani. All of you repeat in your heart: Salmonella typhi, Clostridium botulinum. All of you repeat in your heart all these terms. Yes, Muhammad Zain. Muhammad Zain, am I audible to you? यस बॉट्यूलिज्म इज कॉज्ड बाय बॉट्यूलिज्म। यस क्लॉस्ट्रिडियम क्लॉस्ट्रिडियम बॉट्यूलिनम। यस वेरी गुड। यस अलामा वाली बेस्ट यू टेल। Clostridium botulinum is the botulism is caused by Clostridium. I ask typhoid fever. Salmonella, Salmonella. Repeat in your heart, Salmonella. Typhi. Salmonella typhi. Salmonella typhi।